I had the privilege over the last day, it seems like the last week, of organizing and coordinating the workshop we had on the Survive and Thrive After Peak Oil, in which we had about 75 people come in a day early to create an agenda to talk about the various opportunities and challenges that face all of us as we go into the next few years about the world of peak oil and climate change and all of the other challenges. And we started with four pages of what do people want to get out of this, from very specific to very broad. We talked about the kind of people who were, some of them were very expert in peak oil, some of them just curious about the topic and really didn't know very much at all. And sort of somebody said, you really ought to come and hear this, and they said, okay, I'll come. We had people who were interested in very specific advice to how to make contacts and build communities. One of the things that the biggest questions that we had, the biggest challenges, was a gentleman who talked about the importance of integrity and knowing the truth and telling the truth. And he did this starting out by reading from the diary his mother had written as a German citizen in the summer of 1945, regretting that she had not stood up to say her truth about National Socialism in Germany. And he believes that we all face the challenge of trying to sugarcoat things and not talk about what is really a threat. So the group set topics, and we ended up with one-third of the group offering to lead sessions on a variety of things, sessions for which they had not prepared, to an audience they did not know, because it was an open space meeting in which the group was going to set its own agenda. And we had four broad themes of topics. We talked about personal finance and investing. We talked about creating the readiness to act and information and how to know what to trust and messaging and building community. We had specific questions about transportation and housing and food. And we talked about the bigger trends and creating local economies. So we had a variety of topics. I will be preparing, right now the output of the report is in a stack about 2 inches thick of flip charts. I will be writing that up for the ASPO newsletter or the Oil Drum or some of the other magazines that are available to share those conclusions with everyone. But one of the questions that we were all left with, which I think is very important, is if herbivores eat plants and carnivores eat meat, do locavores eat their neighbors? So with that, I will turn it back over to Jim. And